Now, the problem when you're doing like such a sort of analysis of the cognitive system is that there's just so much stuff going on. Like there's sound, light, like there's so many people moving around you. It's very difficult for you to really get a grasp of how to handle a complex system like this, because it's always changing and there are just so many variables. So the question is, like, everybody, I assume every, you know, every human being with an interest in this stuff has to deal with it. How do you study and control a system with so many variables? So Western answer was always to look harder at what was out there. So they saw like these planets out there and comets out there, and they were like, let's study it in more and more detail and try to block out whatever is being contributed by this portion of our cognitive apparatus, and then we'll have this objective viewpoint of what really the object out there is. Well, so that's kind of where all the stuff that I deal with as a neurologist comes from. This is like, you know, functional MRI, like that guy was commenting on Facebook. This is an EEG, it's brain wave activities. This is a neurosurgery, which is like the apex of this approach to the nervous system. Really just you treat it as a piece of meat and then you do surgeries upon it, and then you treat it just like any other object, right? The Indian answer, though, was to approach this complex system from the inside, because they always, I assume, thought that it was easier understood from the interior perspective than being experienced as an outsider. So that's why I think Sadhguru maybe named his kind of his program Inner Engineering, because really it is what he's doing. He's internally kind of engineering these complicated neural circuits. So this is another metaphorical example. So basically, this is the Western system. They're basically looking at a brain from a third person. Indian system, you don't look with your eyes, you close your eyes, you look with your third eye, essentially look inwards. And that really is kind of the gist of what this talk is about, because I'm saying that what the Western approach found in kind of science terms can in some ways be correlated what the Indian approach finds from the inner terms. Obviously, they're not going to be the same thing, because, like, you know, you are not going to be exposed to every element of your mechanism when you see it from the inside. At the same time, when you look at it from the outside, you are missing out a lot of things that are coming from the inside, right? Again, similar metaphor, like this is a volcano. So you Western approach, you look at it from the outside, look at this mountain and all this stuff, smoke coming out. Indian approach, you look right there, you look out from the eye of the volcano, and that's the view that you get. There is no saying that one is superior to the other. I think they're both very important approaches. Even in India, there have been like third person objective approaches as well. And in the West, there have been some approaches from the first person as well. It's just like the broad kind of outline.